mother always taught her that preach she must obey. Pardon me, dear mother, I am crazy now, for under these titles I can no longer bow. Assisted by her handmaid, a Bible she conceived, and as she gained instruction, so God his love revealed. No more she worked as angels or pictures made by men. Soon she was betrayed and her Bible room was sold. I'll bow to my dear Jesus, I'll pray to God unseen, I'll live by faith forever, the works of men are vain. I cannot worship angels nor pictures made by men. Dear mother, use your pleasure, but pardon if you can. With grief and great vexation, her mother straight did go to inform the Roman clergy. They called up all her woe. The priest was soon assembled, and for the maid did come and put her in a dungeon, laid her soul above. The more she drove her pride, the more she did endure. Although her age was infant, her faith was strong and true. It changed the course of ghostly. Hey, from this lady took, and she with all her spirit pride of life forsook. Before the Pope they brought her in hopes of her return, and there she was condemned horrid flames to burn. Before the blaze of torment they brought her speedily, with lifted hands to heaven then we agreed to die. There being many ladies assembled at the place, she raised her eyes to heaven and begged a flying grace. Weep not, ye tender lady, shed not a tear for me, while my poor body's burning, my soul the Lord shall see. Yourself you need to pity, in Zion's deep decay, dear ladies, turn to Jesus, me no longer stay. In come the big mother, her daughter to behold, and in her hand she brought her the picture made with gold. Oh, take from me those idols, remove them from my sight, restore to me my Bible, wherein I take delight. Alas, my aged mother, while on my roof